Now, we just talked about NTLM and the LM hash. Let's talk about now about NTLM authentication. Now, this authentication mechanism is very proprietary to Microsoft, and it's the default authentication that is used if some specific situations exist. I know some of you guys are going, Dale, it's Kerberos. They're using Kerberos. I know that, except if the following situations apply to you. So it is only used when there are no Kerberos trusts between two different forests and you're trying to share resources. I know. You're thinking Dale learned some new tricks in PowerPoint, huh? Huh? Look very closely at the spinning wheel and email Dale your password, credit card information, and social security number. Another time that NTLM gets utilized instead of Kerberos is if authentication is being attempted by an IP instead of by DNS name, because Kerberos requires DNS or a domain name environment. Also, if one or both of the systems are not a part of the same domain. So don't think that you're not using NTLM, because you very well could be. And the other situation is if you by chance have a firewall that's blocking Kerberos. Wheels on the bus go round. Okay, I'm not going to get that song stuck in your heads. Okay, Dale, so now we know when it's used, but how is it used? Well, it's based off of a challenge response algorithm. Now, whenever I talk about challenge responses, I'm reminded of a movie that I grew up with. In fact, I'm going to give you guys a homework assignment. You can tell your boss or your significant other that you've been assigned the task for ethical hacking to go watch a movie called Mighty Python and the Holy Grail. And I have some caveats here for you, but you got to make sure that you only watch it late at night when you're feeling a little punchy. In it, there's a scene where the bridge keeper is guarding this bridge. In order to get across, you had to answer three questions. And the first question was, what is your name? And Sir Lancelot says, Sir Lancelot. And then he says, what is your quest? And Sir Lancelot says, my quest is for the Holy Grail. And then he says, what's your favorite color? Blue. And he says, okay, you can pass. The next knight shows up and he says, what is your name? And he says, my name is Sir Robin of Camelot. He says, what is your quest? My quest is for the Holy Grail. He then says, what is the capital of Assyria? And Robin goes, I don't know. What? And he gets ejected off the cliff. It's pretty funny. You have to watch it. But that's a typical challenge. And what is the response? If you are who you say you are, then you should be able to answer these questions. In fact, when King Arthur answers, one of the knights says, I didn't know you knew so much about swallows. And he said, well, you have to know those things when you're the king. So again, that's how we verify. Now, the cool thing about this is that passwords are never transmitted because you're just going to respond to a request or to a challenge. As I mentioned before, NTLM came in version 1 back in Windows NT, and trust me, just say no. And I can't even imagine even an NT box out there still that would be running version 1. Because when they released Service Pack 4, version 2 was released, and it was a lot more secure for us. So again, don't think that you're not using it, because you very well could be. Well, let's take a look at how it actually operates. So this is how it works. You've got your client machine. A user sits down, throws the three-finger salute, and gets their login screen. They type in their username and password. Now, Windows takes that password and runs it through a hash algorithm to generate a hash for the password that's been entered. The client then sends a login request to the domain controller, and since the computer has joined the domain controller is very much aware of the hash value associated to that login name. So the domain controller then creates a random string and sends it and says, basically, if you are who you say you are, you should be able to answer this request. The client encrypts this request with the hash and sends it back to the domain controller. The domain controller then goes through, again retrieves the password or the hash of the user's password, and compares it to see if it's the correct answer. If it's the same answer, then you're allowed to cross the bridge. If it's wrong, what? You do not get to pass.